Welcome back to the another video of the same chapter, Expressing the Present. Now, we will discuss present perfect tense. The present perfect tense tells us about an action that completed in the recent past, but whose effects still remain. Means, it tells us about an action which was completed, but its effect remains in present time. Look at the point. It is used to talk about an action that has been completed in the recent past. Means it was already completed in the recent past. Look at the examples. He had just finished the dinner. He has completed his dinner. So, we use here has finished present perfect tense. Number two, she had just gone out. She has already gone out in recent past. So, we use here the present perfect tense has gone. Third number example, we have won the match. We have already won the match in the recent past. So, we use here the have won in present perfect tense. They have cleaned the room. They have already completed the cleaning of the room. So, we use here have cleaned in present perfect tense. Look at the next point. It is used to talk about an action that was completed at some time in the past, but whose exact time of completion is not given. Means the action was completed in the past, but its complete time is not given. There we use present perfect tense. Look at the examples. I have seen a snake in the garden. I have seen it was completed, but when I have seen, time is not mentioned. So, we use present perfect tense have seen. Second example, I have visited the Taj Mahal. I have visited, the action was over, but when I have visited, not mentioned. So, have visited in present perfect tense. Third number, she has posted the letter. Her action was completed, but when she has posted the time is not the time of completion is not mentioned. So we use here the present perfect tense has posted. Last example, the organization has stopped paying attention to our needs. Has stopped means already stopped, but when it was stopped, we don't know the time. So we use here present perfect tense has stopped. Next point. It is used to describe a past action when we think more about its effect in the present. Means when we see the action's more effect in the present time and it was completed in the past. Look at the examples. I have cut my finger. So, it is bleeding now. Second example. She has lost her room keys. So, she cannot unlock her room now. Third example. She has made the tea, so we can have it now. Fourth number, I have finished my work, so I am free now. We think its effect more in present time. So, we use here the present perfect tense. It is used to describe an action that started in the past but is continuing at the time of speaking. Means present perfect tense is used when an action was started in the past but continuing now also. Here are some examples. I have started writing the essay. I was writing in the past but now also I am writing. So, we use here the present perfect tense have started. Second example, Mr. Singh has worked with us for over 4 years. Mr. Singh was working with us, now also he is working with us. So, we use here the present perfect tense has worked. Third number, I have known him for a long time. I knew him in the past, now also I know him. So, we use here the present perfect tense have known. Last example, he has been ill since last week. He was ill in last week, now also he is ill. So, we use here the present perfect tense has been ill. Look at the next point. We use for to talk about a period of time and since to talk about a particular time in the past. it is used to show that an action is repeated several times. Present perfect tense is used when same action is repeated many times. Look at the examples. I have often heard him scold her. Means many times I have heard him scolding her. Second example, Neha has helped me several times. Neha has helped me many times and the same action is repeated. Now, different forms of the present perfect tense. Number one, affirmative sentences. Has plus have plus past participle form of the verb. The bird has built the nest. Second sentence, I have completed my homework. So, with the third person singular number, we'll use has, and with the first person singular plural, second person singular plural and third person plural form, we will use have and past participle form of the verb. Negative sentences, has or have plus not plus past participle form of the verb. My friend has not done the work. My friend, third person singular number, so we use here has not done. With the first person singular plural or second person singular plural and third person plural, we use have not known him. We have not known him. You have not known him. They have not known him. Third number, interrogative sentences. Has, have, plus subject, plus past participle form of the verb. With the third person singular number in the beginning, we will write has. Has he returned my book? Has he returned my book? And with the first person singular plural, second person singular plural and third person plural, in the beginning we'll use have. Have you seen him? Now we will discuss present perfect continuous tense. The present perfect continuous tense is used to talk about an action that started in the past but is still going on at the time of speaking. Means we use this tense when the action already started in the past but also going on in the present moment. Look at the examples. He has been sleeping for 3 hours. So he is still sleeping. They have been building the bridge for several months. The building work was started but they are also building in the present time. Third example, Sneha has been trying to find her documents. Sneha tried to find in the past, now also she is trying to find. Fourth number, they have been playing since 4 o'clock. They were playing, now also they are playing. The actions are still going on in the present time. So, we used present perfect continuous tense. Different forms of the present perfect continuous tense. Number one, affirmative sentences. Has or have plus been plus ing form of the verb. Look at the examples. It has been raining all day. With the third person singular number, we'll use has been. And with the first person singular plural, second person singular plural, and with the third person plural, we'll use have been plus ing form of the main verb. Second number, negative sentences. Has or have plus not plus been plus ing form of the verb. The baby has not been sleeping well. The baby, third person singular number. So, we use here has not been sleeping. Second example, they have not been playing. They, third person plural. So, we use here have not been playing. Third number, interrogative sentences. Has or have plus subject plus been plus ing form of the verb. Look at the examples. Has she been missing class for the last 1 week? Have they been digging up the ditch? So here, she, third person singular number. So we use here has. Then second example, they, third person plural. So we use here have. And continuous tense is used for an action that is going on at the time of speaking. But the present perfect continuous tense is used when we want to indicate the duration for which the action has been going on. The duration is also often indicated by a time expression in the sentence. Look at the examples. The bird is building a nest. The action is going on at the present moment. So we use here is building in present continuous tense. Look at the second example. The bird has been building the nest for the past 1 hour. The action began an hour ago and is still going on. So we use here has been building present perfect continuous tense. I hope all of you understood this chapter. Thank you.